Today, I will show you all the derivatives that you have to know for your Calculus 1 class. And I know they're all over there, but I would like to fit in everything right here on this board for you. For notes, you can check on my Patreon. Anyway, let's go ahead and get started, of course, with the definition of derivative. F prime of a, as a limit, this is the limit as x approaching a. And then right here, you pretty much have the slope formula. F of x minus f of a, and then over x minus a. As you can see, we have y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Here is just the first version. The second version is the one with h. F prime of a equals the limit as h approaching 0. And the h is the distance between this point and that point. So what we'll do is we will have f of a plus h and then minus f of a and then divided by just h. Why do we need a second one though? Because of the following. This is the official definition of the derivative as a function. Here we have f prime of x. Imagine if we put x into this a, that's okay, but if you put x into this a, that a and that a, well, we get x minus x. No, you get 0 on the bottom, no good. But if you put x into this a and that a, it's all okay. So that's why we need to use that. And this is the limit as h approaching 0 of, just replace all the a's with x's. So x plus h minus f of x, and then all divided by h. And these are the definitions in terms of a limit for the derivative. After the definitions, of course, here are the differentiation rules. The first one, I'll put down the constant rule for you. Taking the derivative of a constant c is just equal to 0. And then the next one, everybody's favorite, taking the derivative of a power function, x to some power, let's say n. Keep in mind, x is in the base. The n right here can be any number. It can be 17, it can be pi, it can be negative 2, etc. For this situation, just put the power to the front and then minus 1, and we get n times x to the n minus 1 power. Now, let's say if we have a constant multiple with a function, so c times f. For this one, you can put the c on the outside and then just multiply by the derivative of f, so f prime like that. So just a real quick example, if you are taking a derivative of, let's say, 3x to the fifth power, well, you can put the 3 on the outside and then focus on taking the derivative of x to the fifth power. To do this, use the power rule. Put the power to the front, minus 1. So you have 3 times, this is 5x to the fourth power. And then just multiply, get 15x to the fourth. So that's what that is for. And then the next one is, if we're taking the derivative of a sum or a difference of two functions. So ddx, let's say we have f plus or maybe minus g. For this, you can just go ahead and take the derivative of the first one and then add it with the derivative of the second one. But if it's a subtraction, you just subtract instead. So if you are taking the derivative of x squared plus x to the third power, just do the power rule here. You get 2x to the first power, and then you do the power rule right here and add them up, 3x squared. So that's that. After the sum or difference, of course, we can also talk about the product rule. And this right here, it requires you to remember it. Right here, I will have a way for you guys. Let's write down the f first right here, and also the g right here. And then we are going to just differentiate them separately. The first function, differentiate that, and then the second function, differentiate that. And then you do this times this, which we get f times g prime. And then we are going to add this with this times that, which is g times f prime. Especially if you are doing derivative for the first time, this right here will be really, really helpful. You can check out my other videos for worked out examples for that. After the product, of course, we have the quotient. So we have f over g. For this one, remember, quotient is the opposite of a product. Instead of putting down f and g, let's write down g and f. g goes first. And then just differentiate this and differentiate that. Still do the same thing, yeah? G times f prime, that will go to the top. And then remember, it's the opposite. For product rule, we add. For quotient rule, we subtract. And then we just do this times that, f times g prime. And if we started with a fraction, we'll end up with a fraction as well. We are going to divide this by the denominator g to the second power. Why is this true? You can check on my other video for it. The next one, of course, everybody's least favorite. The chain rule, it's a composition of two functions. That's the f of g. This is how you can do it. You have f of a box, s of something. Inside of the box is the g function. Take a look at this and take the derivative, f prime of a box. And then take a look at this and take the derivative, g prime. For this, just go ahead, put the g function back to the box and then multiply. So right here in the math notation, we get f prime. Use parentheses for the formula, but the box will help you to understand. Inside, you still have the g function. It stays the same, but on the outside, you have g prime that you have to multiply. That is the chain rule. So these are all the different differentiation rules. Now, here are the derivative of the usual functions that you have to know. Let's start with the derivative of some situation from here, 1 over x. This is a very common one, I think you should remember. The answer for that is negative 1 over x squared. For this right here, the reason is just look at this as x to a negative 1, and then bring the power to the front, minus 1. We get negative x to the negative 2. That's how we do it. But it will happen quite often. It's easier if you remember it. Another similar situation is you differentiate square root. If you remember this, you get 1 over 2 square root of x. You will be dealing with square root functions a lot. It's worthwhile to remember it. Why is this true? Because look at this as x to the 1 half power. Put the power to the front, minus 1. We get 1 half x to the negative 1 half. So you see, we have the 1 over 2, and x to the negative 1 half goes to the bottom. 1 half power is the square root. Now, let's talk about exponential functions. The first one, of course, the derivative of e to the x. This right here is very beautiful. It's still just e to the x. But if you are talking about the general case, when you take the derivative of, let's say, a base b to a power x, this right here, you first repeat it, you have b to the x power, but you multiply by natural log of that base b. The reason why is because we can look at this b as e to the ln b power and then raised to the x power. So the function is just e to this times that, so we have ln b times x power. Taking the derivative of this, this thing right here repeats first because it's like e to a box. So the box, right, just e to the same box, it stays. And then you have ln b times x. But look at the box and then differentiate that. This right here is just a number. So a number times x, the derivative is just that number, ln b. So that's why we have the ln b. And this right here is just that, which is just that, which is just b to the x. So that's the general case for the exponential function. Now, the inverse of them, of course, here is the derivative of natural log. Here we get 1 over x. But the general case for that is taking the derivative of log base b of x. This right here is similar to this and same idea, right? Similar idea to this. Or you can just use the change of base formula for this. It's easier that way actually. This is the same as saying ln x over ln b, right? Take the derivative of that. And we can put the 1 over ln b to the front by this rule. So we have 1 over ln b times the derivative of ln x. What's this? That's precisely 1 over x. And remember, this is just a constant, so let's multiply by lmb on the bottom. So that's how you get that. Now, these are all the non-trig functions, and you know what's coming. The next one, let's put down the derivative of sine x. And let's also put down the derivative of cosine x right here as well. Because sine and cosine, they are best friends in calculus. The derivative of sine x is positive cosine x. The derivative of cosine x is sine x. But one way to remember that this is negative because cosine starts with a c. All the trig functions that start with a c, you have negative derivative, so negative sine x for that. Next, let's take a look at the derivative of tangent x and also the derivative of secant x. They are also best friends. The derivative of tangent x is secant squared x. The derivative of secant, it first repeats, you have secant x, and then invites best friend, which is tangent x. They are both positive because you don't have c. Now, if you are looking at the cofunctions of this and that, if you take a look at the derivative of the cofunction of tangent, of course, cotangent x, well, it's the cofunction of this, you get cosecant squared x. But you see the c, so you have negative derivative. Likewise, when you have the derivative of the cofunction of that, which is cosecant x, you know right away the c, you should get negative derivative. Same thing, it repeats, right? And then just a coefficient of that. It repeats, so you have the cosecant x, and then its best friend is exactly that, so cotangent x. These are all the trig functions. Let's talk about the inverse of that. So, taking the derivative of the inverse sine x, in fact, you just need to know 3, and the other 3 pretty much come for free. This right here gives you 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared. 1 goes first, and then minus x squared. Why? Because the domain of inverse sine x is from negative 1 to 1, likewise for this. But in fact, the endpoints are not differentiable for the inverse sine function, so you also don't get the derivative if you plug in negative 1 and 1. Once you know this, if you differentiate inverse cosine, it's just the same thing, but combining with what I told you guys earlier, we see the c, make sure you have negative derivative. Next one, let's talk about the derivative of inverse tangent. You will see this a lot. The derivative of this is 1 over 1 plus x squared. The domains for both of these are just all real numbers. By the way, the limit as x approaching infinity of inverse tangent of x is pi over 2. You should also remember that. It happens quite a lot. Now, once you know this, you can expect to know the derivative of the cofunction of that, which is the inverse cotangent x. Again, you end up with negative derivative and the same thing right here. Now, let's move to the derivative of inverse secant x. Hopefully you don't see this one often, right? 1 over x times the square root is the opposite of this. X squared goes first and then minus 1. So here's the deal. If you use James Dewar textbook, then this is okay. But if you use other textbooks, then you will see an absolute value around the x right here. And the reason is depending on the domain, depending on how they define the inverse secant. I don't really like this often, so I don't really ask my students this often. But I'll tell you, this right here depends on your textbook. So I'll say C textbook. Right? And then, of course, you can also have the derivative of the cofunction of that, cosecant, and then the inverse of that. You see the c, so you know you have negative derivative, and then rest same thing, x times the square root of x squared minus 1, and again, you have that absolute value depending on your textbook. All right, almost done. Ladies and gentlemen, I still have one little space. This right here totally deserves to be on here. The derivative of x to the x power. You can do exponential, you can do implicit differentiation by taking log first and then set the equal, just y equal to this, and I set log L on both sides. Or you can look at x as e to the ln x, and then do what I told you with that. I will leave that to you for you to try. Right here, the answer for this is, it repeats, you have x to the x power, but you have to multiply by some other stuff. And that other stuff is 1 plus ln x. I did it in one take. Well, this is actually my second take. If you want to see my previous take, which I took a while, you can check out the link in the description. But no cut for this video. If you want to see the notes, again, check out the links to my Patreon. And best of luck to you in your Calculus 1 class. And you know it, that's it.